our technological world is going through a paradigm shift. Thanks to the amazing progress of robotics and electronics, more and more of the engineered systems surrounding us are increasingly controlled by smart autonomous devices. Often, these devices can be spread throughout the system and move freely. They can communicate from time to time, and they can make decisions autonomously. Think, for example, of the emerging smart electricity grid, where your fridge or your dishwasher will optimally adapt their electricity consumption, where solar panels will optimize their production based on the weather they observe. And even you, as a local consumer, can be partly controlled by regulating electricity price. Such systems, where computing devices and robots interact in closed loop with the physical phenomena they want to control, are called cyber-physical systems. Other examples include networks of planes, industrial processes, or energy-efficient green buildings. And this new paradigm opens up a multitude of possibilities for improving the performances of the system, the range of application, its costs, etc. But this comes with huge challenges. Typically, in a cyber-physical system, the physical part of the system and the cyber or computational part are intrinsically related, so that one cannot disassociate the behavior of individual parts when designing the whole system. It turns out that mathematically, the behavior of these two features are extremely hard to reconcile. Somehow, our mathematical tools are very bad at handling these joint equations. In recent years, researchers have devised a general methodology to tame such systems. In a nutshell, one makes a mathematical model, cuts it into very small pieces, and ends up with a finite abstraction of the system called an automaton. Unfortunately, this leads to very heavy models, so that in practice, we're only able to apply this to very small systems. We call this the curse of dimensionality. Our daily work in my team aims at improving such techniques by mixing methods from mathematics, computer science, or control theory. Recently, for example, with collaborators from MIT and Princeton University, we've introduced a new class of mathematical functions, which we called path-complete Lyapunov functions. Somehow, these mathematical tools allow us to circumvent this curse of dimensionality, but only for particular families of cyber-physical systems. Because of their hybrid nature, mixing combinatorial and analytic properties, we think that they might be good candidates to tackle much more cyber-physical systems. Today, we are working at generalizing these techniques, and we hope that tomorrow we'll be able to apply them to even more general cyber-physical systems, like a self-coordinating network of planes, for instance. Well, of course, there are many challenges along the road, but if you want to learn more about them, you know where to find us.